imprecise words.
What up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. What's going on, guys? Today we are going to be, well, not today, in this video, I should say, because it's kind of going to span over a few days. Jess and I and Irie, we just landed moments ago, like maybe an hour ago.
That's a lie.
It was like 2 hours ago. But yeah, we just got to Port. Where are we? Where are we right now? Port Cove? I believe we're in Port Cove, Australia. It's just north of Cairns. I'm gonna get into the pronunciation of Cairns in this video because it's spelt Cairns. The Aussies, with their accent, they call it Cairns. So I guess I'm gonna call it Cairns for the rest of this video. I feel weird calling it Cairns, even though it's spelled Cairns, but as I said, we just got in, and yeah, I'm gonna show you guys around the Airbnb. So yeah, let's go.
The living room. Bam. Here's the master bedroom, the room we kind of just threw up all our belongings in. Bathroom, kitchen, you know, standard kitchen.
We're actually gonna make a conscious effort to eat more meals than not at home, just because, you know, these trips, they're a lot different now with a baby, as you can imagine. You know, things are a lot more expensive than they once were. A year ago at this time, Jess and I probably would have just bunked up at the local hostel for $10 a night, but now we're in Airbnbs, you know, moving on up. Yeah, this is the coolest part, I think, of the place. It's sort of like a patio set, and Jess is already out here enjoying things with Irie May.
Irie.
So yeah, that was the Airbnb, and yeah, we're really happy with it. Like I said, we just got here, so, but yeah. Port Cove. Hey, this is Port Cove, yeah?
You can't get it right.
What is this?
Palm Cove. You've said a million different names, like every time.
Palm Cove.
Palm Cove.
Palm Cove. Correction. Rewind to the start of the video. Palm Cove is where we are. North of Cairns, and yeah, we're gonna enjoy it. There's lots of stuff to do here. The Great Barrier Reef is here, and you say great, I said that. Great Barrier Reef. Great Barrier Reef!
When again, see them within. Seeing teeth on the floor, leaking again. We hold the door, we build the bridge. We hold the core sender, cease and desist to your thieves, nigga. Please do a board, I could feel when you're forcing it. Still in a bored rhythm. Boy, I take the torches and go and get some decent decor. Is you gon' ribbon or will you jump? Get some more ribbons for the born winners from the jump. Niggas don't listen to their whole mission was a bust. No sitter, but it's crunch time. Shooting in the clutch. The midsummer sunshine found me on my ones. Face dripping, hate swimming through your bloodlines. Motherfucking judge saying going to the one time. Yeah. Come and take a stroll in the mud.
Wow, that fish is the coolest thing I've ever seen.
I started doing it only a couple days.
Now I'm scared.
Yeah, Great Barrier Reef. If you guys ever get a chance to do that, highly recommended. Highly, highly, highly recommended. For me, it was probably in the top three coolest things I've ever done traveling, for sure. But back to something that I said earlier in the video, and that is how times have changed since we've had Irie. You know, trips are a little bit different than they used to be. You know, as parents, you could still have fun, you could still go on trips, and they're just different than they were before. And, you know, accommodations is just one of the things that were different for us, that are different for us, I should say. Cost, when you have a baby, everything in life just becomes more expensive. The Airbnb is just a perfect example of that, you know. As I said before, we would stay in hostels that would be anywhere from like $10 to $40 a night, but now we're in an Airbnb, which is like 100 to, I mean, God, you can go pretty much limitless with that. But you just have to adjust your budget. Whenever Jess and I go on trips, we always try to do it for as cheap as possible, which means we could go on more trips if you're not spending as much money as the average person was. For us on this trip, eating in more times than not was huge, because restaurants, as everyone knows, it adds up really quick. So it's just an easy way to kind of offset, you know, the price difference from like budget hostels to an Airbnb. But yeah, as far as like adventuring with a youngster goes, Jess and I had to do the tag team. You know, she had Irie for a bit and I went out, then we flip-flopped, then I had Irie entertaining her and making sure she's all good, and Jess went out, and then like when it's all said and done, we'll come back and talk about what we saw and how it was. You just have to adapt, and that's part of that I'm learning as a new parent, that you have to do. Adaptation, learning to go with the flow, and just doing things differently. Just because they're different doesn't mean they don't have to be fun or stop being fun. Irie's at an age right now where, you know, she's not crawling around, she's not running around, so she's pretty easy to take care of. You know, we just pick her up and she goes where we go, so that's a huge thing. But mainly, you know, we're just learning to be more flexible, adapt to situations, and just kinda go with the flow. Now, going on this little excursion we did to the Great Barrier Reef, it was actually interesting. We took like a, I don't want to say it was like a high speed boat, but it was going pretty fast, and the waves were like really choppy, and people all around us were getting seasick and puking, and you know, we're sitting there holding Irie, you know, just like looking around like, is Irie okay? Like, what's going on here? Just like hoping that, you know, she is fine. As parents, you still have that anxiety, like, oh my God, what if she starts feeling sick or she's not enjoying it? Like, what can we do? We're on a boat. Yeah, it is what it is, you know, thank God she was okay. You know, it was kind of cool, you know, as a dad, just looking at Jess hold Irie, looking at the beach and out to the ocean, and having those types of things are like memories that are just like burnt into my mind. So that's, you know, what I wanted to say. If anyone was like me, you're worried about your life coming to a complete end when you have kids, don't worry, it won't. You just have to change. Things are different, but they're amazing. But yeah, after we wrapped everything up at the Great Barrier Reef, we spent a couple more days in Cairns, and it just so happened that two of my teammates from Melbourne were up in Cairns as well, so we linked up with them, they had a car, and we went on an old-fashioned road trip. I guess you probably want to see what that looked like, huh? Let's go!
And Parksy, they just took the, well, they didn't take the baby. We let them take Irie for a little spin. She's snoozing in the stroller. Well, yeah, they said they would watch her for a minute so we can go up here and check out this bridge, because it's not really a stroller-friendly path, but we're just having a laugh to ourselves because we're about 50 meters from Irie, but it's probably the furthest, like, both of us have been away from her at one time her whole life. That's probably not true, but it's. I mean, I'm trying hard to think of another time we would be.
We haven't been together once.
Yeah, we haven't been together without her for ever. So, yeah, you know. Thank you.
This trip was kind of interesting because it is a two-parter. After we wrapped up in Cairns, we hopped on a plane again with a baby, again. She did good, again. Thank you, Harry. But we headed for Sydney, and it was for a good reason. I was asked to participate for Team Canada in a Canada vs. USA charity series, and it was to raise money for concussion research. But yeah, we also used that invitation as an excuse to go back to Sydney, this time with the fam. Brought Jess and Irie there for their first times. And if you go to Australia, you gotta go to Sydney, right? Just to see the Opera House and all the beautiful sights they have there. We also have a couple friends in Sydney. What up to the Crowders if you guys are watching? Didn't really film that much just because as much as I wanna like share our experiences traveling and everything, there is a part of me too that really cherishes just enjoying the moment and not always having, you know, your device or your phone or your camera or, you know, whatever it is out. Cause I mean, this is it. This is it. When you are looking at a screen, you're not really present. So it's about finding balance. But yeah, I've been rambling on enough. I want to show you Sydney. Well, the footage that I do have. So what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Brand new truck, butter sauce seat, 4 point something with a low ride something. Ain't nothing better than a ride out the hood with it. Who looking better and damn you looking good in it. Take a chance with a nigga in the choice ride. Listen to the CDs I play inside. Mos Def, J, Prince, and Stevie. Marvin Gaye, Led Zeppelin, and Biggie. And when the evening is over, love, gonna find a nice spot for the rover, love. Do things to make the man in the moon blush. My mind race, but I tell my waist don't rush. Use an upper echelon piece, so when you find it's a stash, then you don't freak. You wanna nibble on a nigga ear, and do all the things that make a nigga wanna get near. Oh, I'm a Queens representative. Get wild by any means, my incentive is. When we done, I start it up again and ride around with you.
Since you.
My. Oh my god.
That's the face of a woman recognizing her first white hair.
I can't believe it.
Are you responsible, Irie?
Cause you my special friend, Me and you, I think we should ride. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Second part, my ride is like art. We get creative in it when we take it out and spin it. The back seat is the canvas we painting on. Abstracted work we creating on. The TV's in the back in the dash too. Got Miss Napkins and bamboo. Don't worry, the tint's past the legal one. Outcast banging loud in my eardrum. The way the wheels spin, coming through the chill wind. Outsiders looking in with the ill grin. Fuel injected, brand new inspected. Emissions got tested, details perfected. Got the armor all touched.
That's where it's at.